Hey, good day. Our lesson for today is about Boyle's Law by Robert Boyle. So let's have a short introduction about Robert Boyle. Sino ba siya? Robert Boyle was an Anglo-Irish natural philosopher, chemist, physicist, and inventor. Boyle is largely regarded today as the first modern chemist and therefore one of the founder of modern chemistry and one of the pioneer of modern experimental scientific method. He is best known for Boyle's Law, which described the inversely proportional relationship between the absolute pressure and volume of a gas. If the temperature is kept constant within a closed system, the absolute pressure and the volume of a gas are said to be inversely proportional to each other. So mamaya paliwanag natin siya ng mas detalyado. Among his works, The Skeptical Chemist is seen as a cornerstone book in the field of chemistry. He was a devout and pious Anglican and is noted for his writing in theology. So, magaling na tao to. Ano ba ang Boyle's Law? Ayan. Boyle's Law states that the volume of a fixed quantity of gas is inversely proportional to pressure. Ibig sabihin, yung volume and pressure, they are said to be inversely proportional. Ibig sabihin na inversely proportional po sa Tagalog, magkabaliktad sila, no? Paano magkabaliktad? If pressure increases, sabi nga dito, no, the volume will decrease and vice versa. Ayan, no? Sabi, the relationship means that when pressure goes down, the volume goes up. Take note and considering that the amount of gas or the quantity of gas is fixed, hindi siya magbabago, and also the temperature is constant. Yon. Take note that, okay? So we have four quantities kasi na dinagamit sa pag-describe ng gas law. Oo. Four main quantities, which is the pressure, volume, temperature, and amount of gas. So Boyle's Law used to compare pressure and volume, noting that the other quantities are constant. Yon. So ano pa? So we can say also that Boyle's Law, ayan na, using a graph, paano natin siya maipapakita? Halimbawa, ano ito? Pressure volume inversely proportional. Kung papansinin natin dito sa graph natin dito, no? Kapag ang pressure, this is the pressure, the rise and the volume, the run. Kapag po tumataas, ayan, sa graph natin, ibig sabihin tumaas ang pressure, what will happen to volume? Volume decreases. Ayun, no? Diba? Remember, we are considering the temperature and amount of gas are constant. And kung ang pressure naman ang bababa, ang mapapansin mo, yung volume naman ang tataas. O, diba? Vice versa sila. At ang mga gas, usually, when you exert pressure on it, ano makikita nyo mo? The volume decreases. Ano? Let's have a concrete example. Let's use a syringe. Let's take ito, some simple syringe. As you can see, the gas molecule inside the this container, no, moves rapidly. But if you make the container more, sabihin natin mas maliit, you compress it more smaller, the volume decreases. And what will happen to the particles? As you can see, it moves rapidly o mas gumagalaw siya ng mas mabilis. So we can denote here, or we can say now that when volume decreases, ayan, lumiit yung volume, we can say that the pressure will increase. Ayun, di ba? Kung babalik na rin naman natin, ayan ha, nilakihan natin yung volume. What will happen to the motion of the particles inside the container? It will move slower. So it only shows to us that when the volume increases, pressure naman will decrease. Ayan. Di ba? At the volume increase, there is a decrease in pressure. Ayan. This is the explanation by Robert Boyle. Okay? Ano ba yung formula niya? Okay. According to Boyle's Law, pressure and volume are inversely proportional to each other. It means mathematically that P is inversely proportional to V. Or pwede nating isulat as P is equals to K over V. Ano ba yung P? Ang P po ay pressure, V is volume, and K is a proportionality constant. Ayan. And rearranging this, we can have PV is equals to K. Or the product of pressure and volume is equals to K. Karaniwan, ginagamit ang Boyle's Law sa pagkukumpara ng dalawang sitwasyon. Meron tayong before at saka after. Dito, pwede nating sabihin na P1V1 is equals to K and P2V2 is equals to K. Ayan. So, we can rewrite the equation as P1V1 is equals to P2V2. Ayan. So, ito, sample tayo. Sample number 1. A tire with a volume of 11.41 liter reads 44 PSI on a tire gauge. What is the new tire pressure if we compress the tire and its new volume is 10.6 liters? Okay, we can use here Boyle's Law. No? Our formula is P1V1 is equals to P2V2. Ayan. Substituting the values, yung P1 natin, 44 PSI, times B1, 11.41 liters, is equal to P2, wala. V2 natin, 10.6 liters. So, to simplify this and solve for P2, we are going to divide both equation with 10.6. So, we can cancel 10.6. Ayan. So, matitira na lang natin is P2 now is equals to 44 PSI times 11.41 liters divided by 10.6 liters. Ayan. So, we can cancel liters now. PSI na lang unit natin. No. So, the answer here is P2 is now equal to 47.36 PSI. Or, pwede nating i-round off. Magiging to signature, magiging 47 PSI na lang. Kung whole number. Okay, another example. Sample number 2. A syringe has a volume of 10 cc's or 10 cubic centimeters and the pressure is 1.0 atmospheres or ATM. If you plug the end so no gas can escape and push the plunger down, what must the final volume be to change the pressure to 3.5 ATM? So using the formula of P1V1 is equals to P2V2, substituting the values, we have 1.0 atmospheres times 10.0 centimeters cube is equals to 3.5 atmospheres times B2. O, solve for B2. So, divide natin yung dalawa, yung magkabila ng 3.5, makakancel. So, V2 na lang, V2 is equals now to, eto, 1 times 10 divided by 3.5, cancel lang ATM, centimeter cube ang unit. So, V2 is equals to 2.9 centimeter cube. Ayan, or 2.9 cc's. Okay, so let's have another example. Solve naman natin manually. So, lipat tayo sa... Okay, yan. Dito tayo sa whiteboard. Susulat tayo. So, let's have this example. For example, a scuba tank contains 20.0 liter of air at 30 degrees Celsius and 1.5 ATM. Assuming that the temperature remains constant, what volume of air is required to fill the tank to a pressure of 40 ATM? So, in this scenario, in this situation, ito, trivia muna pala tayo. Trivia. Alam nyo ba ibig sabihin na scuba? Hindi yan yung pinangkakaskas sa lababo. Scuba means self-contained underwater breathing apparatus. Yan yung ibig sabihin ng scuba. Ayan. So, balik tayo sa ating problem. Ang una nating bibin dito sa scenario na to is 20 liters of air at 30 degrees Celsius and 1.5 ATM. Sabi, yung temperature hindi nagbago, remain constant. So, ibig sabihin, may palatandaan na tayo na Boyle's Law to kasi titignan natin kung ano yung constant eh. Constant ang temperature. So, what volume of air is required? So, tinatanong yung V2, no, to fill the tank to a pressure of 40 ATM. Ito ano muna tayo, ano? Let's think muna. isipin mo yung ating pressure from 1.5 naging 40. What happened? It increased, tama. So what do you think will happen to our volume? From 20.0 liters, then dapat bababa siya. Ayun. Ang laki nung tinaas ng pressure, so bababa itong ating volume. Tara, solve natin. So ano ba yung mga given natin? Okay, lagay natin yung given natin. Okay, unang given, we have P1. Meron tayong P1, which is equal to 1.5 atm. We have also a given of V1. Ang V1 natin is 20.0 liters. Tapos may given tayong P2, which is 40 atm. And ang tinatanong sa atin ay yung P2. Ayan. So ano nga ulit yung ating formula? Ang formula natin ay P1 V1 is equals to P2 V2. Ano yung tinatanong sa atin? V2, di ba? V2. So we can now simply derive this equation para diretso na tayo. Paano gagawin natin? Ano ba yung katabi ng V2? P2. So ilipat mo na lang sa ilalim yun. Shortcut yun. Oo. Para hindi ka na mag-divide. Ganon din yun. So our formula would be equals to V2 is equals to P1 V1 over P2. Ayan. O, napansin nyo, no? Itong P2 nilagay ko lang sa ilalim. O, pagka nakadiretsyong ganyan, pwede yun. Yun din yun. Oo. Okay. So now, we can now start solving. Ano? Substitute na natin yung mga values natin. So ano ba yung una nating value? So we have, write natin, V2 is equals to P1. Ano yung P1 natin? P1 natin ay 1.5 atm. So 1.5 atm times V1, which is 20.0 liters, divided by P2 natin ay 40 atm. Okay, naalala ko yung sa sinabi si math teacher namin. Okay, dapat daw itong equal sign na to, lagi siyang nakagitna rito, eh, no? Tandaan nyo yan, ha? Hindi siya po pwedeng nasa taas. Mali yun, mali. Okay, so we can cancel now atm. Matitira na lang liter unit ng V2. So we can now proceed to computation. Pwede na natin siyang i-compute. So we just simply multiply 1.5 times 20 is equals to 30. So 30 divided by 40 is equals to 0.75. So our V2 now, uy, natakpan ko pala yun. Teka, nasa likuran ko sinulatan ko. So sa baba na lang, our V2 now is equals to 0.75, okay, liters. So ito na ngayon yung ating V2. Ayun. Lumiit nga. So tama tayo, ano? Tama tayo sa sinabi natin. So we get the answer. So ganun lang kadali po ang mag-solve ng Boyle's Law. So yun lang po. At maraming salamat sa inyo, sa inyong pakikinig. Aha. Ito yung sinolve natin kanina. Ito yung sagot natin. Ayan, tama. 0.75. Salamat sa pakikinig at huwag kakalimutan mag-subscribe sa ating channel. Okay, Sir Jeff Classroom. Thank you po.